Now, what are the core beliefs of the Jews? One important belief that the Jews have is that they believe in the scripture called Tanakh, which is, you can call, the Old Testament of the Bible. So you have the modern day Bible, which has the Old and the New Testament, and you have the Old Testament only, which is believed and read by the Jews, which is also called in the Hebrew language as Tanakh. So this is the scripture that they believe in. The core belief there is to believe in oneness of God. And this is mentioned in book of Deuteronomy chapter number 6, verse number 4, where Moses, peace be upon him, he said, Shema Israelu Adonai Eloheinu Adonai Echad. This is a Hebrew quotation which translates, Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord. So he's referring to the children of Israel, and he says, Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord. This is exactly the same message that was repeated by Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the Quran, in Surah Ikhlas, Surah number 112, ayah number 1, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed, Qul huwa Allahu ahad, say, He is Allah, the one and only. Now the question comes, so what is their further belief? They are waiting for a future coming prophet, a future coming Messiah, who's going to take the Jewish community out of all the troubles and miseries that they are in. Now this is mentioned in the Bible in several places. Interestingly, our claim here is that this prophecy or this future telling of a future coming prophet refers to none other than Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says this in the Quran, in Surah Araf, Surah number 7, ayah number 157. Those whom they follow, that is Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, those amongst the Jews and the Christians who follow the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, whom they find written in their own scriptures, that is the Torah and the Injil. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala testifies in the Quran that the Jews and the Christians, they are to follow a prophet who is mentioned in their scriptures, that is the Torah, the Jewish scripture, and the Injil, the Christian scripture. So there are prophecies mentioned in their scriptures. Now some of those prophecies are, as mentioned in the Old Testament, in book of Deuteronomy, chapter number 18, verse number 18, is a very, very popular prophecy, which the Christians claim that it refers to Jesus Christ, and the Jews are still waiting for this prophecy to be fulfilled. What our job and our responsibility is, to inform our Jewish friends, and those who are about to talk about this subject, or those who are even interested in taking the sides of either Israel or Palestine. Deuteronomy 18:18 speaks where God says to Moses, I will raise them up a prophet from among their brethren like unto thee, who in whose mouth shall I put the words, and he will not speak by himself, but all that we shall reveal to him. So this prophecy is talking about a future coming prophet who is going to be brethren to the Jews. Now, if we go back in history and look at the progeny of the Jews, they come from the children of Isaac, peace be upon him, who happens to be the son of Abraham, peace be upon him, Ibrahim alayhi salam. Now, Abraham, peace be upon him, had two sons, Ishmael and Isaac, Ismail alayhi salam and Ishaq alayhi salam. From their progeny, from the progeny of Ishmael alayhi salam comes the Arabs, and from the progeny of Ishaq alayhi salam, Isaac peace be upon him, comes the Jews. With these two progenies, they happen to be the cousins. Now in the Bible, the language of the Hebrew is, when you refer to somebody as brethren, it refers to those who are your cousins. So it is very likely that it's referring to these two progenies that come from the seed of Ibrahim, of Abraham. So while the prophecy is saying from your brethren, it cannot be a prophet from the Jews or the children of Israel. It has to be a prophet from a cousin progeny, and that happens only to be the Arabs. Now interestingly, after Prophet Ishmael, there wasn't any prophet amongst the Arabs up until Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. So if this prophecy refers to anybody, that refers to Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. And it further says, like unto you, O Moses. So the prophecy is that the similarities between Moses and Muhammad are going to be same. And both became the rulers of their people, both implemented the law of God on the earth, both lived normal lives, both married and had children, unlike Jesus, peace be upon him, and other prophets, and both died natural deaths. So all of this proves that this refers to none other than Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Furthermore, interestingly, right in the Bible, in the Old Testament, in the Jewish scripture, the name, the Arabic name Muhammad is mentioned. In Songs of Solomon, chapter number 5, verse number 16, it reads in the Hebrew language, Hikko mamitakim vikullo Muhammadim. Now, if you go on Google and type Songs of Solomon chapter 5 verse 16, it will put the verse there and read it in Hebrew. You know, you have the audio there. You click it and it will read, Hikko mamita kim vikullo Muhammadim. The name Muhammad is mentioned there. Now, we are not saying this is a prophecy about Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. But the interesting part is, what is an Arab name doing in a Hebrew scripture while this was not a common name for them? Unless they had the prophecies of a future coming prophet whose name shall be Muhammad, and they are now talking about him. Moving further, are there other prophecies in the Old Testament? There are several. For example, the one we discussed, Book of Deuteronomy chapter 18 verse 18. Book of Deuteronomy chapter number 33 verse number 2. Book of Isaiah chapter number 29 verse number 12. Book of Isaiah chapter number 42 verse number 1 to 11. Book of Isaiah chapter number 60 verse number 1 to 11. It's further mentioned in Book of Habakkuk, chapter number 3, verse number 1. In Book of Haggai, chapter number 2, verse number 7 to 9. Book of Jeremiah, chapter number 28, verse number 9. In several other places in the Old and the New Testament, there are innumerable prophecies mentioned of a future coming prophet, which refers to none other than Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. So I would say these are the core beliefs that they have. Believe in one God, believe in the scripture, believe in the prophethood, and believe in a future coming prophet. And that is our responsibility to inform them that that is none other than Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him.